I could have been a sailor, could have been a cook, a real life lover, could have been.
John Yeager has been a big part of the face and the voice of Keithley Instruments to customers around the world. John Yeager's lifelong fascination with electricity and electronics began with a crystal radio set that he built himself as a teenager. In 1950, he graduated from Case Western Reserve University, then known as the Case Institute of Technology, and soon after began his 60-year career at Keithley Instruments as the company's second employee.
Said, well, you can't do that. We just can't change the laws of physics to do that. And this young engineer said, well, sure we can. We have John Yeager. And I thought, that's really the perception of this guy out in the field. That he's like Scotty on Star Trek. Everybody just goes to him. He'll just know it. He could do it. He's John.
Electronics technology has grown dramatically from the vacuum tube-based instruments of the early 1950s. And John has grown right along with it, making lots of friends along the way, both within Keithley Instruments and among the thousands of customers around the world who he's worked with over the last six decades. Customers and companies as far away as New Zealand have long referred to him as Mr. Wizard.
First thing comes to your mind when I say John Yeager?
Mr. Wizard.
Mr. Wizard.
Remember the cartoon, Mr. Wizard, come save me. John saved me many times over the years.
Mr. Measurements, I mean, this is a guy that was very inspirational to me, taught me what I needed to know about low-level measurements.
Booth that have used some of our equipment, they always say, yeah, I've talked to John Yeager about that.
Who's that old guy that I talk to all the time? Seems to know what he's talking about. That's John Yeager. Everybody knows him.
Along the way, he shared a lot of himself with his friends and colleagues, from his love of sailing on Lake Erie, world travel, and bridge playing, to crossword puzzles and ham radio operations. Over the years, he's also taught dozens of Keithley engineers things they never learned in college. He quickly became the go-to guy whenever anyone was stumped on a tough measurement problem.
Didn't have a good solution for immediately. I could always go to John. He could handle any esoteric problem you threw at him. And if he couldn't think of an answer immediately, he could always go to his file cabinet, which was loaded with tons of applications and work that
he can take a very complicated problem, and he makes it down and simple and says, look, it's Ohm's law, this, and this. And then you go, oh, I should have known. But that's the way it is when you've got 50 or 60 years of experience. Nobody rattles your cage.
Insightfulness on how to take his 60 years of experience and be able to work a problem for a customer.
I didn't realize coming out of school how much I didn't know. And I, after a while, figured out that John probably forgot more than I ever learned in school.
We've been working for like 20 years to try and capture all his knowledge. You know, we've got it into, you know, the low-level measurement handbook, we've got it into the switching handbook and a whole bunch of different handbooks. But you know, we still haven't got it all. Maybe we ought to take his file cabinet and put it somewhere where maybe we oughtn't dunk John's file cabinet ever.
John's trademarks include his beard and his bow ties, but even more significant are the lessons about persistence and being a good listener that he's taught the people he worked with over the years.
But really, I mean, he worked so hard to make sure the customer understood, the customer got the point, and that we did right by the customer.
Pretty much they call in and they say, talk to John Yeager. And they're like, well, I couldn't talk to John, so I'm talking to you. So he was Keithley Instruments.
why did John stay at Keithley so long? And I think the answer is very simple. He loved this company, and he just loved the kinds of measurements that we were able to do and working with customers to make them feel like they can do these measurements too. He's Mr. Wizard.